Hey guys, Blue Yoshi here, and welcome back to Super Mario Galaxy! Last time, we entered the gate and obtained the Power of Flight, giving us the ability to traverse the Common Observatory like never before. Today, we are entering our final dome, the Garden, and collecting 5 stars in our first galaxy that we are going to be doing. So yeah, that's essentially the idea of this episode, and well, without further ado, let's go! So quickly, I just want to say that I've been somewhat dreading this episode. Because, well, if you can't tell, we are nearing the end of this Let's Play. In fact, we only have about 10 episodes left. So, not even. You know, so, yeah, I've kind of been dreading this episode because we're starting the end, but I guess we're doing it anyways. So, let's go into this blue star and enter our final dome here. Alright, so as you can see, there are 4 different galaxies in this area. There is no Bowser galaxy, no boss, because, well, boss is going to be the final boss. But we do have 4 new galaxies here today, so that's nice. Now, you may be asking yourself, well, which galaxy are we going to be doing? And on most occasions, I do like to do the one with the least amount of stars. But for this time, we have a special occasion, and this time, we're actually going to be starting with the second least amount of stars. In fact, the galaxy that we are going to be doing today is the Dreadnought Galaxy. So let's fly to this galaxy, get this party started, and let's start this video here. So here we go. So the Dreadnought Galaxy. It is very much like the Battle Rock Galaxy in that, well, its missions, its layout, just its level design, it's very strikingly similar to the Battle Rock Galaxy back in the Fountain. So it's basically Battle Rock 2.0. So yeah, we will be getting some missions that may look similar to that. You know, this whole area uses the same music as Battle Rock Galaxy, so that's something to note here. Not right now. Right now it's playing Space Fantasy, but eventually it will. Well, would you look at that? I did not mean to do that, but it just happened. So yeah, for this first area, all you need to do is traverse to the opposite side, bounce on that guy's head, and you will be on your way to fly to this area right here. This area, all you need to do is kill all of these guys. You can kill them by spinning and then jumping on their head. They'll give you 1 coin to leave you of any health problems that you may have, so that is quite neat. But yes, once you beat them, you can go into this pipe, and this is the main area of this level, of this mission, sort of. You know, there's like 2 main areas in this mission. It's kind of hard to explain, but yeah. Anyways, so immediately we are greeted by this Electro dude. All you need to do is jump on over him. It's not too difficult to deal with. And then right here, you just need to wall jump across these. They do give you quite a bit of time to do this, so you don't have to worry about anything. But I suggest you just wait here for it to go back, just to be safe. So anyways, once it goes back, you can just go across. I suggest going to the left like I did to get the extra 3 lives. You may not think you may need them, but it is quite helpful, so yeah. Anyways, let's just long jump all the way over here, change the gravity. Alright, so for this area is just a little more difficult than our previous area. First of all, you need to wait for these to leave. Then what you're going to need to do is wait for that one to go up, for the next one to go up, and then for the last one to go up. Now, there is a crossroads here. There's a left and a right path. The left path will just take you back to the start if you want to go there for any reason. But for the purposes of this video, I'm going to go to the right path, because that is the right path. See what I did there. Anyways, right here, you have a spin. Just need to ground pound on it, then spin. Make sure you place yourself correctly, and don't get hit by any of those bombs. Okay, excuse me. Game? Yeah. So anyways, these things will allow you to fly all the way uphill. Make sure you get into the pipe and we are on our way. So ideal, we do have some bombs here. You don't have to really worry about them. Just make sure you're not in the way and you'll be perfectly fine. You do have these green enemies right here. I'm not sure what they're called, but call them green bouncies for the sake of this video. And all you need to do is just bounce on their head to the top and make sure that you do not hit those electric little fields, I guess is what you'd call them. Because those will paralyze you and then you'll be losing time because these are actually on a time limit and they'll actually fall eventually, so you better watch out. Especially on the very top, that is most difficult. Anyway, so what we are right here, if you had a bomb from Oleo, you could get that one up. But again, one up, so pretty much useless in this game, so you don't really have to worry about anything. Yeah, all you need to do is wall jump over there. You can do that, or you can do like what I was doing right there, and just go to the very top and, well, enjoy your life. Anyways, we are flying off to our final area in this first mission here. In which, Space Fantasy goes back on. I thought Battle Rock would be, but, you know, whatever. We do have these new enemies. They are, like, little, electric, battle stations, I guess. I don't know. And all you need to do is just knock it by the laser, and then you won't get electrocuted, so. You're welcome. Anyways, so for this area, it is quite simple. All you need to do is, well, I keep on saying that, wow. Apologies. But, you see, the thing that you need to do here is you need to have this guy follow you. And I accidentally took the wrong path and they're gonna collide here. But if you can do it correctly, what you want to do is have this bullet bill follow you, go over here and then take the right path once you get over here. And this will open up this little water thing and flood this area. In which will make this platform right here buoyant, which will allow you to obtain the next area of this mission here. So yeah, all you need to do for this next part, get over here to this little floating platform. Okay, I'm having just a little trouble here. There are two different ones you can go on. The left one, which will take you very far to this question mark block, which will give you a lot of stolets. As you can see. And then the right path, which will take you to, you know, where you actually need to go. Make sure you utilize your long jump in this level, because it is quite useful for, you know, the amount of platforming that we are going to be utilizing here. So, there we go, made that jump. Grab that star bit. Alright, so, this part is a little tricky, you need to watch out for those electric laser things coming down from those battleships. But if you take your time, it is not too difficult to remember. Each of these go on their own path, so therefore you can just go like behind them on their own path and you will not get hit. That is, if you're good at this game, which I am not sometimes. But anyway, somehow I survived that, didn't get hit once, and let's grab our first star in the Dreadnought Galaxy! Alright, let's go on to our next mission right here in the Dreadnought Galaxy. This next one, I believe, is going to be, let me think. I do not remember what this next one is, but, yeah, let's not save our game, let's not waste your time right here, let's go into here. Let's go to the Dreadnought Galaxy, let's continue this quest right here. So, our next mission is going to be Dreadnought's Colossal Cannons. Yes, this is the one, yes. So yeah, essentially in this mission, all you need to do is just dodge these cannons and get on your merry way. Of course, we won't start there. We still have some new things to explore too, but yeah. Yes. Welcome to the galaxy. So yes, all you need to do on these is just go to the right, and these will go forward. If you go to the left, they will go backwards. Now, there is a spot under me, as you can tell, but all that is a bunch of bombs and a case holding a 1-up. So, if you care about a 1-up, then you can go ahead and do that. But I personally don't care for them, so I'm not going to do it. But feel free to do it on your own. For this area, we have some chain chomps coming down at us, trying to eat us. Watch out for them, they are coming out of these dog houses, if you couldn't tell. So it is quite tricky. Make sure that you don't step on your own. Don't go into the electric field. A little difficult, but if you can get all of the switches, you will make all these disappear and install this, which is quite useful, so yeah. So let's continue onwards. Remember, go on to the right. Twist these forwards. Alright. Okay, now we have some enemies right here that we first saw in the kitchen. And all you need to do is spin. It's just like King Caliente, you just need to have the watermelons go back into the face, and then you'll be perfectly set for this next area, which we're going to be jumping onto. So yes, this next area is essentially the largest area in this whole thing. It's the final stretch, you could say. See, what you need to do is you need to go onto this next platform right here, and it will start to move, as you probably guessed. As it moves, you're gonna have to stay on this platform and dodge these balls that are flying at you. I didn't even mean to do that, but I guess it just came out of my mouth, gosh. Anyways, so yes, these balls will explode upon impact. So yes, and then there will be different ones that you'll have to traverse across. Ones on the top, ones on the bottom, ones on the right, one on the left. So you do have to watch out for that. And of course the lasers and balls. There's a lot you need to account for in this area, but if you just take your time and be very watchful, it's not too difficult here. Now, of course, once you go on the up, down, or up, left, and right ones, that's when you're gonna have to start dealing with gravity. So if you're bad with these controls, well, just essentially imagine that they're inverted, because that's essentially how it works here. You can go up here, and if you're good with the Z-axis, you can grab some stomachs. A little more balls, and then we can go down here, and this is where our imaginary checkpoint is. Alright, so we do have a wall here. You can go on his head, do a high jump like that, grab a one up, show him that, and then if you're fast enough, you can get back on here. Now you may think, oh no, we're going into this landmine, but, well, we didn't. So yeah, all you need to do is just wait on there, and it'll be perfectly fine. So we have some more bombs going at us. You could hit that, but I'm not going to. The ones on the left and right, I'd say, is the most difficult in terms of gravity. That was, in fact, our only left and right ones. So there's only one of those special ones in this whole course. So that is quite nice, but yeah, I kind of just messed up right there. I don't know why I got that one up. You guys already know what that is. I guess that happened. So we just gotta wait right here for it to come up. And you jump up here. Watch out for the gravity here, cause, well, specifically the controls, so somewhat inverted. Well, not perfectly inverted. I'm still pressing up when I'm going. But the left and right is quite... it's hard to explain. So yeah, you have to be very mindful of your C-axis in this level. Okay. So yes, there was another imaginary checkpoint right here. And this is when it starts getting crazy, because you get bombs coming at you from all the angles. And a lot of them. So, gotta watch out for that. Anyways, we are on our final stretch. As you can see, the star is glowing. You can see it right there. All you need to do is stay on here. Travel over here, and as we jump on here, jump on his head, and that will be a second start today. Anyways, we have yet another mission to go here. We also have two others afterwards, but they are quite quick, so I wouldn't exactly call them full-blown missions. So yeah, we have one star here left. Let's fly to the Dreadnought Galaxy, and let's collect it. So, our third and final mission here is going to be the Revenge of the Topman Tribe. So, Let's see what we can do here. The master of the toddling tribe again, and then remember when I said at the start of this video that it has a lot to do with Battlelock Galaxy? This is what I mean. In Battlelock Galaxy, you know, we fought the Topman tribe that was, you know, invading the Battlelock Galaxy. So now we have the return of them. So, as I was saying, it has a lot to do with Battlelock, you know. Kind of related, I'd say. Alright, just jump up here. Go through that thing star. Now, in this planet, what you need to do is you need to lure these guys close to you. And then, once they're close enough, you want to hit them into that, electric, thing. And that will have both of them go down. You can talk to this Luma, and he's going to make a shortcut for us. And transform. That's also what he's going to do. Let's go into his thing star and see what the next planet has in store for us. Yes, essentially right here, what you need to do, ground pound, and, well, there's going to be blue stars here. Or blue star chips, I should say. So what you need to do for most of these is you can just, you know, walk around and get them. But there is one that's quite a tricky one. Specifically this one right here. What you need to do is get this green dude over here by you. You need to jump on his head. And, well, that's where you're gonna get them. Eventually, if you get all of them, you'll be able to go right here. Make sure you let go of the A button to allow you to drift like that. And we're going to our next area. So this area is quite difficult because, well, as you can see, we have those bombs coming at us yet again. So yes, well, essentially the idea is that we need to go into our blue stars and that we need to go through here and not get hit by these bombs. Oh shoot, I think I, yeah. So yeah, you just need to make sure you time it correctly. If you don't want to go, you can just hold it right there. Just hold the A button. Alright, we're timing that correctly. For these last few ones, all you need to do, bring it and then let go of the A button. And that will allow you to drift and go into that grand... not grand star. Launch star. Alright, so for this next area, the idea is that you need to jump over these little lasers, you know. So, the idea here is to grab this good shell, and, you know, keep it. Now, if you hit this one, it'll get a coin for you. If you hit this next one, it'll give you a coin. And of course, both of these heal health. Well, why do that when you have these? Oh, shoot. I did not mean to do that. Anyways. I'm gonna have to take my word for it then that this chest right here holds a 1-up mushroom. So, if you were not going to use a coin from those previous ones, then I suggest, you know, using it on that. Anyways, as one can imagine, we are nearing the end of this area right here. Going on to the boss. Alright, and let's see what he has in store for us today! Top. Let's go. So, this is our rematch with him. If you remember from last time, what you need to do to defeat him is to jump on his head and then spin him into these little electric things. You know, quite simple. Of course, now he has his little red dudes helping him, so that is anything. He also has fire abilities, but he's not too difficult if you know what you're doing, and, well, we just harvested his star. So, that will be our third star in this episode. Alright, so we have two more stars left to go here. One is going to be a secret mission in that previous mission that we just did. And then the other one is going to be a speedy comet. So stay tuned for that. Anyways, so for the secret mission, it's actually not very hard to find. In fact, all you really need to do is go to the first planet and, well, I guess I'll show you. But, yeah, it's not that it's hard to find. It's that it's extremely difficult once you do find it. And I think you might recognize what's going on once we get there. Anyways, so yeah, all you need to do is just go on to the underbelly of the first planet. Quite simple. And then there's a pipe. Yeah, as you can see, we have the little trash dude right here. So,
You know how hard it is keeping a dreadnought clean? It's all it comes and drops a load of trash in the ammo to buy. Hey, we have a plenty of bombs you can use to blow up all this trash.
Wow, I don't even know what that was. It's obviously not a robotic voice. I don't even know what that was. Anyways. So you do see these little coin things that's smoking where you want to throw your bombs. Of course, try to do it tastily, because you do not have much time. It takes them about 7 seconds for them to explode, so you need to throw them all before the 7 second mark. So it seems that we might actually do it on a first shot here, but let's see. Our left one is gone. Let's hope that this right one hits too. Yeah, there we go, first try. Wow, I guess I was obsessing over something that wasn't too difficult in the end. I don't know. I remember in my previous playthroughs when I was a kid, I had much trouble with that, so I don't know. You blew up all the trash to bits. Thank you. Well, thank you too, because that will be fourth star in this episode. Alright, and as you can see, there's only one more left to go. In fact, a very quick one, as one can imagine from a speedy comet. Essentially, all we needed to do is do our previous mission. You know what I mean. The one where you have to defeat the Topman Tribe. Revenge of the Topman Tribe. You need to do it faster with, you know, some added enemies, in which I'll be showing you where they are. So, yeah, let's fly over here. And let's grab our... Excuse me, game, I would very much like to press that. And let's grab our 89th star? I don't know. I haven't been keeping... No, 88th, I believe. 88th. Yeah, 88th star. But yeah, so, the Topman Tribe speedrun. Okay, so for this first area, you might have noticed. There's a red guy here. You can't jump on their heads. So first of all, you need to get that red guy away from you. Then you need to lure this green dude over here. Need to make him follow you. And then you need to jump on his little hat. And continue on. Alright. This next area was practically unchanged. There's still only two that you have to hit. But I do find it a little more difficult. But I don't know. It could just be the same thing. You could get that 1-up right there, but as I said, 1-ups are sort of pointless in this game. So you don't need to get them if you don't want to, and of course, time is a necessity here, so definitely be mindful of that. Anyways, let's go to the next planet here. Of course, it's just going to be like normal, only with, you know, the red ones here. So it's quite simple, but of course, that last one is quite tricky if you don't have the green dude. Okay, so 5 minutes left approximately. Okay, now where is the blue star jet right here? Alright, that guy just flew right to us. That's quite useful actually. Alright. Okay, let's try to fly past. Wow, I just got poked right there, I guess. Of course, make sure that you let go of the A button for those. I know I'm being quite repetitive when I say that, but like seriously, it took me a while to figure that out when I was a kid, so yeah. Make sure you keep your A button off when you're trying to drift. When you're not trying to drift like this, of course, hold it. So yeah. Okay. Alright, just go behind the trail of these. That's the best advice I can give you for this part. Besides, of course, drifting. Alright, so we only have our final few areas left to go here. Of course, this area. Not too difficult if you know what you're doing. I did get hit last time. So, I guess we'll see if I can do it better this time. You don't exactly need a life shroom, but I guess it'll be useful. Does his laser not even come out of him? I think his laser didn't even come out, okay. Yeah, so if you get electrocuted, you will lose your Koopa Shell, as you saw earlier. So that is something to note, but of course it's not a very difficult portion if you know what you're doing. Alright, so let's go to our final area right here with the boss, the top menu, you could say. I always thought that sounded like a British thing. Topman. You know, like someone that would like do trains and stuff, maybe? No. I feel like I've heard it from like Thomas the Tank Engine. I don't know. Okay, just need to not get hit by his little friends here. We should be set to do this. We have 4 HP, and he only has 1. And I'm about to hit the heal. Oh wow, I'm failing right now, but I actually did hit him, surprisingly. With 2 minutes and 44 seconds left, let's grab our final star today, and our final star of the Dreadnought Galaxy, for now. So yeah. I will see you next time on Super Mario Galaxy!